Senator Aimee Marcos over the weekend told reporters that the COM election simply junk, or literally put in the trash bin, the People's Initiative signature forms it received earlier instead of issuing or producing withdrawal forms. Your thoughts on the senator's comment?
Well, I beg to disagree. That's very undemocratic. Millions of Filipinos signified and signed to the People's Initiative. Alam niyo ho, ang parte ng isang demokratikong proseso ay yung pagkukumbinse at meron din na proseso para mag-withdraw doon sa pinirmahan nila. And that's why the COMELEC is right when they now issue the form for its withdrawal. But, you know, interestingly, until now, walang nag-withdraw. And in the two hearings conducted by the Senate investigation, tinanong yung Commission on Election, wala rin na nagre-reklamo in any election officer or COMELEC office for that matter.
In hindsight, sir, how do you actually assess the move of using the AIX as well as the TUPAD programs to lure the public into signing the People's Initiative? Because while it did boost the campaign, or rather the signature campaign, it however left an unpalatable taste to the public as well as several lawmakers. Now, this is one of the sore points wherein critics of the People's Initiative are poking.
May proof ba, Katrina?
Yes, sir, indeed. There was a video circulating, not just a video, several videos circulating wherein there is a woman, I think if I remember correctly, telling the people that they have to sign this specific form, which is in line, I think, which was done during a TUPAD program. I just couldn't remember as of the moment the actual city, but yes, there are several videos proving it, sir.
Was that woman presented before the Senate hearing?
Not really, sir, but the Senate hearing is not the only avenue to actually validate those pieces of evidence. But indeed, there are videos circulating. What do you make out of that, sir? Was it a wise move to actually lump the TUPAD and AIX program with the signature campaign, regardless whichever camp or whichever People's Initiative support group pushed for this to happen?
Iba yung chismis, iba yung sabi-sabi, iba yung katotohanan, Katrina. In fact, two agencies of the government presented before the Senate hearing, the Department of Labor and Employment and the DSWD, nagsasabi na walang katotohanan yung mga paratang or propaganda na ginagamit against this anti-People's Initiative movement. So siguro let's stick to the facts, sa katotohanan lamang tayo. I think the Senate investigation, dapat tapusin ni nila yan. Lahat ng kanilang ipinisentang witnesses na nagsasabing walang naresibi na pera. Although some were told na merong ayuda na ibibigay. But, you know, is it enough to prove that their consent were vitiated in signing the said petition or the People's Initiative? So tingin ko yun na lamang ang natitirang o available na proof na sa nakalipas na dalawang investigasyon sa Senado ni isa sa mga testigo na iprinisinta na Senator Aimee Marcos ay nagsabing wala silang natanggap na pera o ayuda na ibinigay. So ito lamang ay mga sabi-sabi, and let's stick to the real facts.
Okay, you're discounting the senator's allegations as hearsay and rumors, but a fact is President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. during his state visit to Vietnam in late January said that he is not sure if the PI is still a viable option to actually amend the charter. Your thoughts on the president's statements? Does that actually...
Go ahead, sir. The subpoena of the latest pronouncement of the president that there was no signature buying or giving of IOTA. That's the latest pronouncement of the president. You should, you know, conduct research on that.
Yes, sir. I cover Malacanang, so I definitely know that the president said that. But at the same time, he also said that he is not sure if People's Initiative is still the viable option to amend the charter. With that statement, go ahead, sir.
I respect the president because, as you know, he's not involved in pushing for this people's initiative. But yung mga lahat ng alingasngas, lahat ng aligasyon, ito'y mga paratang laman na until now, isang buwan na nakakalipas since the investigation started, wala rin proof na inipipresenta. But the you know, the biggest proof that we can present is that millions of Filipinos, in fact more than 12% as required by the Constitution, have already signed the signature sheet in pushing for this people's initiative. So ito dapat ang pagtuunan ng pansin, hindi yung mga aligasyon at alingasngas that remains to be unproven.
Okay, you seem still very optimistic, sir. Where are you now in this People Initiative campaign? How many signatures have you gathered so far?
Katrina, alam mo, ang aking focus ay ang Bicol region. And I can certainly say that in the Bicol region, we were able to meet the requirement of 3% for each legislative district. Sa kabuuan, ang sinasabi ng mga convener at kasamaan ko dito sa People's Initiative ay more than 12% na kami. So, but there are some districts who have not yet submitted their signatures to the Commission on Elections due to the fact that the COMELEC suspend yung pag-receive nito. So, tingin confident kami na ito ay maaabot namin, and in due time, we will file the necessary petition.
Sir, what's your timeline so far? Any target date as to when you would complete the process?
As long as we determine that all the legislative districts have complied with the 3% mandated by the Constitution, then we are ready to file the petition.
Okay, so no time frame, no definite deadline, sir, so far. It's an open, it's an open-ended thing. So far, sir, the budget season is up and coming, as well as the filing of the certificates of candidacies. Do you think this would actually affect the People's Initiative campaign, your push to amend the charter via People's Initiative?
Somehow, it will affect, because, you know, the priorities will be different, especially the different government agencies. But hindi naman na ito ay isang rason or hadlang upang kami ay tumigil sa aming pangangalap ng pirma and eventually to file the petition. So we will still move and continue to, you know, get the support of the Filipino people with regard to People's Initiative.
Is there enough time, sir, considering that in about 6 months the Congress will be busy tackling the 2025 national budget?
You know, ang trabaho ng Kongreso ay kakaiba dito sa mga nagsusulong, nagtutulak ng People's Initiative. So, in fact, upon filing the petition, and if there's this required signatures attained by the People's Initiative movers, then the COMELEC will certify to the compliance, and they will set the plebiscite. So wala ditong partisipasyon ang Kongreso. Mm-hmm. Hindi may istorbo ang trabaho ng Kongreso.
But the support coming from the lawmakers, sir, do you feel that that would dwindle, given that you mentioned earlier na some priorities might shift in the coming months?
Signatures are there, intact. Mm-hmm. And sa tingin ko naman ay yung mga pumirma doon ay hindi maapektuhan kung mag-shift man ang priorities ng ating mga mambabatas.
All right, sir, one of the common criticisms against the People's Initiative campaign that you launched is that, or that your group launched, is that the forms were in English, using highly technical language allegedly. In hindsight, do you think it would have been wiser if you placed it, if you worded it in Filipino na mas understandable to the bigger chunk of the public?
Alam mo, yung aming pag-distribute ng mga signature sheet wherein nakapalaman na doon yung one-liner proposed amendment sa ating saligang batas, ito ay napaliwanag sa ating mga kababayan sa barangay level at tinatagalog natin, in our case, sa Bicol region, binibicol natin. At sinasabi lang natin, ganun kasimple, payag ba kayo na ang botohan sa Kongreso pag nagkaroon ng proposed amendment or revision sa ating konstitusyon ay joint voting. Meaning magkasama silang magboboto at yun ay bibilangin bilang isang asamblea. Sila, naintindihan naman nila. So, sa tingin ko, walang technicality, walang, hindi sila nahirapan sa pag-intindi ng joint voting.
Mm-hmm. Sir, one of the critics of the People's Initiative is the Duterte family, particularly Vice President Sara Duterte, who we all know still holds a huge or a significant political sway in the country. How do you think this affects your PI campaign?
Well, that's part of the democratic process. If there is a avenue wherein we can explain it to the people and solicit their support, there's also a process as where somebody, a group against the initiative can campaign against it. Even the senators can campaign against the people's initiative, and that's what they're doing now. So I fully respect their stand and their opinion to this. But as you know, if you will check back, sila rin yung nagsusulong ng reformations or revisions of the Constitution. In fact, that was the platform of her father, President Duterte, when he ran for president. So hindi ko alam kung bakit sudden turnaround on this People's Initiative na one-liner lang naman ang isinusulong natin. But siya nga, federalismo yung kanyang isinusulong. And that was his platform when he campaigned and won the 2016 presidential election.
Mm-hmm. But they, I think, if I remember correctly, they weren't doing that via People's Initiative. So where and when do you actually draw the line, sir, to say that it's time to abandon the People's Initiative campaign and instead shift to either CONCON or CONAS?
Well, the thing with CONCON and CONAS, Katrina, is that there is this infirmity and ambiguity in interpreting the provisions of Article 17, which is the amendatory provision. Kaya nga po nagkakaroon tayo ng People's Initiative para linawin yung ambiguity or infirmity. Yung interpretation ng whether voting separately or voting jointly, even our eminent constitutionalists cannot agree on how do we proceed with Article 17. As you know, and if you're covering the Senate hearing, Justice Vivi Mendoza and Justice Ascuna cannot agree on how do we interpret Article 17. And so this is really the solution. Ang taong bayan na nagsasabi na dapat joint voting instead of separate voting, dahil ito nga yung nagiging balakid sa pag, to effect the needed change in our Constitution. And this has always been the deadlock, and sometimes the Senate weaponize the ambiguity or infirmity so as not to proceed with any constitutional amendment.
Sir, frankly speaking, kaya po ba mas optimistic kayo with the People's Initiative route is because in the past years, history would show us that the Senate has been blocking several attempts of the House to change the Constitution either via CONCON or CONAS.
Well, tama po kayo, and that is on record. In fact, Katrina, tayo naging chairman ng constitutional amendments in the 18th Congress. At naipasa natin for the first time yung economic amendments. At ito'y itrinansmit natin sa Senado. Kinahod pa natin, explicitly sinabi pa natin, voting separately. Pagdating sa Senado, dead on arrival pa rin. So, we cannot, move forward, and we cannot go on like this. And that's why that ambiguity and infirmity is now being remedied directly by the sovereign Filipino people through this People's Initiative.
And finally, sir, what will be your recourse should this People's Initiative campaign either fail or just remain stale before the COMELEC?
There are remedies at hand, but we fully trust the COMELEC and the other institutions that this will they will give a chance on this people's initiative. Ang amin ay ang suporta ng milyon-milyong Pilipino. Ayun ang pinagagalingan namin ng lakas ng loob, and then we will continue to push for this meaningful constitutional amendment.
All right, and with that, we will have to wait and see on what happens next. Thank you so much for joining us this Monday morning, former Congressman Alfredo Garbin Jr.
Salamat, Katrina. Magandang umaga.